Nobody safe.
Buenos tardes, y fútbol hermanos. Es ist wieder mal Zeit für ein neues taktisches Meisterwerk. Und zwar werden wir uns heute Thiago Motas 2-7-2 Formation genauer unter die Lupe nehmen. Und ich werde versuchen, den aktuellen Plan von Thiago Motta, der bekanntlicherweise bei Bologna sehr gut funktioniert, in der eFootball-World zu integrieren. Und ich denke mir, es ist wieder mal an der Zeit, was Neues zu bringen. Wir hatten so ein Experiment schon mal mit dem Legendary Real Madrid Squad von José Mourinho. Jetzt werden wir uns mal den Thiago Motta seinen Spielstil anschauen und ich werde euch dann anschließend zeigen, wie ich das Ganze in eFootball integriere. Und mit dieser Mannschaft, mit dieser Taktik werden wir die nächsten Livestreams starten und gucken, ob das Ganze in der Division 1 gut oder schlecht funktioniert. Und let's go, let's watch the video. Vamos!
While their starting lineup is a 4-2-3-1, the two pivots rarely play in a parallel
standard
position,
basic.
One pivot usually pushing forward into midfield, and Bologna will often start their attack with one holding midfielder. Motta made headlines a few years ago after stating he wanted his team to play in a 2-7-2, with the goalkeeper acting as the first midfielder. At first glance, it could be interpreted as a formation that looks like this. However, in reality, Thiago Motta's 2-7-2 is meant to be read from side to side, meaning there are two players out wide on each flank and seven players in the center.
1-2 1-2-3-4-5-6-7 1-2 2-7-2
In this case, it makes much more sense to consider the goalkeeper as the first of the seven midfielders and provides us good insight into how Motta sees the game. Wanting the goalkeeper to be an active part of the team's
Vamos, Neuer.
Their main objective is to hold possession in deep areas, drawing in the pressure in order to isolate the attackers against the defenders and quickly create chances when there is space to attack. In fact, while their possession is high, their field tilt is relatively low, suggesting that the majority of possession happens in their own half. Their ability to hold possession in deep areas is second to none, and one of the most interesting rotations can be seen instantly from goal kicks. With the keeper in possession, the center backs will start either side of the goalkeeper, with the fullbacks in a deep connected position. However, as they play it around the back, one of the two center backs will push into midfield to reform the double pivot. This structure means the goalkeeper instantly becomes an active part of the game and provides the team with an extra man, making it easier for them to find the free player, as with this rotation, they will almost always outnumber the opposition's press. Depending on the structure of the opposition's press, they will usually look to move it indirectly into the free player by going through the two players in the center. The rotations don't end there, and a lot of the times, both center backs will rotate forward into this position, with the fullbacks rotating into a more central position to form a back three with the
This is very interesting.
With the wingers dropping...
Hoppala! Die zwei Außenverteidiger werden sozusagen zu den Innenverteidiger, bilden mit Neuer die Dreierkette. Da beginnt das Ganze. Die zwei Innenverteidiger rücken auf. It's very interesting.
With the wingers dropping into a slightly deeper position to give support.
Sehr interessant.
A good example of this rotation can be seen in their recent match against Fiorentina. With the keeper in possession, the center back Bukema rotates forward into the double pivot role, allowing Abishai to move into a position in the half space, where he acts as instant support to the fullback if needed. As the keeper is closed down, it frees up an indirect pass into the centre-back, and now Bologna have space to play it forward into the attacking set of
players. For more active build-up positions, the base structure is a 4-3-3,
The fullbacks rarely push forward and stay in close proximity to the centre-backs. This is because if one of the centre-backs pushes forward, they can instantly form a back three for defensive cover. Further up the pitch, the two midfielders will stay in a wide position in support of each winger. This is because Bologna will often look to move the ball directly out wide into the wingers, and in this way they can instantly have support from the midfielder and look for a 1-2. But by far the most dangerous player is the striker Xerxes. His positioning is extremely dynamic, often dropping deep into midfield and receiving the ball directly from the defenders.
Fox in the box. We need the fox in the box in this case. So I take Romario instead of Dirkze. What he is doing, the fox to box, falling down, der lässt sich fallen. Genau das, was der da jetzt gerade gezeigt hat mit Dirkze, stelle ich mir mit Romario vor. Fallen lassen, Räume schaffen für die Äußeren. Fox in the box.
His heatmap highlights his active role in the game, often hovering from flank to flank and constantly looking for the ball. As a result, he ranks in the top 94% of players in the league for expected goals, and in the top 88% of players for expected assists. Bologna's offensive style is extremely entertaining to watch, and their ability to create chances from a deep position means the opposition never has time to get settled. However, as we saw from his thesis, Thiago Motta's defensive intensity is just as important. Thiago Motta is heavily reliant on counter-pressing the opposition as soon as
Genau. Druck. High intensity. Because of the high intensity, we need the possession game. Wir brauchen Ballbesitz. Weil in the defense, when defending, keep a high defense line to put pressure on the opponent from the front lines. After losing possession, players closer to the ball quickly move to pressure on the ball holder. Das heißt, auf German, mit Ballbesitz drinnen, steht die Viererkette oder die Abwehrreihe hoch. Es wird Druck ausgeübt, high intensity und mit Ballbesitz und mit Quick Counter hat man die Möglichkeit, diesen Spielstil in der Defensive auszuüben. So, ich brauche Ballbesitzspiel und viel Druck ohne Ball. Deswegen Possession Game. The best coach for Possession Game at the moment is the Pep Guardiola version from FC Bayern Munich. Possession Game 88 and Tight Possession Booster plus 1 for every player. Also habe ich mich dazu entschieden, diese Thiago Motta 2-7-2 Formation, wie eben gerade gesehen und gezeigt, mit Guardiola zu spielen. Es gilt natürlich, das Bestmögliche aus der ganzen Sache rauszuholen. So viel zum Trainer und so viel zum Teamspielstil. Und jetzt noch kurz ein paar Worte zu den Spielern. Der Gerard bindet die beiden Innenverteidiger als Anspielstation. Dann haben wir einmal Box-to-Box, einmal etwas offensiver im zentralen offensiven Mittelfeld zwei Spieler und dann die zwei Flügelspieler, die ganz draußen am Flügel aktiv sind. Wir sind wieder bei 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2, 2, 7, 2. Auf der rechten Seite wie auf der linken Seite zwei Außenspieler und in der Mitte brauchen wir ein Fox in the Box. Das ist auf jeden Fall die Main-Taktik von Thiago Motta. Genau das ist es. Die zwei Außenverteidiger rutschen zurück, bilden mit dem Tormann die Dreierkette und von da heraus wird das Spiel gestaltet. Und die zwei IV gehen weiter nach vorne. Die müssen ein bisschen Fußball spielen können. Die brauchen Low-Pass, Lofted-Pass, Tight-Possession. Als Beispiel, wer ist hier ein No-Go? Wer ist hier ein No-Go? Van Beuten, No-Go. Koulibaly, No-Go. Van Dijk, No-Go. Ruben Dias, Solala. Beckenbauer, super. Super. Perfekt. Passen muss er können. Passen, bewegen. Kunde auch okay. Ramos, sehr interessant auf dieser Position. Ramos. Also ich würde noch Ramos und Beckenbauer empfehlen. Ansonsten Maldini, Baresi ist gut. Marquinhos geht auch. Aber ich würde sagen, Maldini, Baresi, top. For this one. Nobody's safe.